Now see the third figure of speech is simile. Simile means what here? Simile means direct comparison between two things or two objects with the help of the words as or like. Now let's see the example of simile. White as a feather. The example of simile is, or either first example, blue as the wings of halcyon wild. Blue as the wings of halcyon wild. In this line, there are two things compared directly. Which are the two things? This line has simile because in this line, the blue color compared directly with the wings of halcyon wing, or with compared directly with the wings of halcyon wild. That's why this line has simile, and also you can see the clue, the word as. That's why it has simile. Once again, I repeat it, this line has simile because in this line, the blue colored garment is directly compared with the wings of halcyon wild. That's why this example, this line has simile. Now let's see the second example of simile. The second example, find out like the plumes of peacock. Second stanza, third line. You can see second stanza, third line. The line is like the plumes of a peacock. Like a plumes of a peacock. Purple and green. This line has also simile. In what way you explain that? This line has simile because in this line, the plumes of peacock, okay, the garment, the cloth is directly compared with the plumes of peacock, purple and green. Now this word is there, like means what here? Like is a clue of simile. But the direct comparison between two things, which are the two things? The first thing is that purple and green plumes of peacock and the cloth, the garment which the weavers are weaving. That's why we say that the direct comparison between the cloth, the garment and the plumes of peacock, purple and green. That's why this line has simile. Now see the third example of simile. Third stanza, third line. White as a feather, white as a cloud. See, white as a feather. White as a cloud. Once again, this line has simile because in this line, funeral shroud. Do you remember that funeral shroud? In the funeral shroud is directly compared. The color of funeral shroud is directly compared with white feather and white cloud. That's why this line has also simile. Now see, like the first line as. Second line, like third line also has the word as with the help of these few words and also the direct comparison between two things. All these three lines have simile. Do you understand? Now let's see the another figure of speech that totally opposite with simile, that metaphor. Metaphor means what here? Indirect comparison between two things. In simile, we see the direct comparison between two things, two objects, and in metaphor, opposite with that simile, number four, metaphor, indirect comparison between two things. Indirect comparison between two things. It's also the important figure of speech, metaphor. Indirect comparison between two things. Now see the example. The first line, weavers weaving at break of day. First line of this poem, weavers weaving at break of day. Weavers weaving at break of day. This line has metaphor. Why this line has metaphor? Because in this line, the birth, the childhood. In this line, the birth. We can say the childhood. The stage of human life is indirectly compared with break of a day. And this time referring here to the phrase break of a day is morning. That's why we say that this line has metaphor, because in this line the birth, the childhood of a man is indirectly compared with break of a day. That's why this line has metaphor. Now the second example, second stanza, first line. Weavers weaving at fall of night. Weavers weaving at fall of night. And you know very well that fall of night means what here? At the time of evening. This phrase, fall of night. Once again, you can explain in what way this line has metaphor. Now you explain, this line has metaphor because in this line, the youth, because in this line, the youth, the second stage of human being, youth is indirectly compared with fall of night, means the evening. Do you understand? This line shows that the indirect comparison between the childhood and break of a day. The second line, weavers weaving at fall of night. In this line, here the indirect comparison between the youth, the second stage of human life, indirectly compared with fall of night. Now see the third example of metaphor. The third example, which is in the third stanza. Now you can find out the third example of metaphor. What do you weave in the moonlight chill? The third example. What do you weave in the moonlight chill? This line has also metaphor because in this line, the indirect comparison between moonlight chill, and you know that moonlight chill means here night. The indirect comparison between moonlight chill with the death, third stage of human being. The third stage of human being, that death means old age. We can also say that old age. This stage is indirectly compared with moonlight chill. That's why this line has also metaphor. So in this poem, there are only three examples of metaphor. I think you understand very well that the two figures of speeches, that simile and metaphor, both are opposite with each other. In simile, there is a direct comparison, samorasamor honari tulana, pratyakshapane honari tulana, and metaphor, indirect comparison between two things, means a pratyakshapane honari, don goshtin madhili tulana, it means metaphor. Okay? Now here, the next figure of speech is inversion. The next figure of speech is inversion. Inversion means what? The arrangement of words is not in a correct prose order. Number 5, inversion. The arrangement of words is not in a correct prose order. म्हणजे शब्दांची मांडणी वाक्य रचनेनुसार नसते, त्यावेळेला त्या लाईन मध्ये कोणती फिगर ऑफ स्पीच असते? इन्वर्जन. हिअर इज ओनली वन एक्झाम्पल ऑफ इन्वर्जन इन दिस पोयम, दॅट व्हॉट डू यू वीव इन द मूनलाइट चिल. एक्झाम्पल इज व्हॉट डू यू वीव. इन द मूनलाइट चिल Now see the arrangement of words. The answer is this line has inversion because in this line the arrangement of words is not in a correct prose order. The half answer is that this line has inversion because in this line the arrangement of words is not in a correct prose order. And write down into the second line the correct prose order is. The correct prose order is. And you can write down the correct prose order. And see here the structure of this question. What do you weave in the moonlight chill? Here is that noun and chill means cold. It's an adjective. So the arrangement of these two words, the correct prose order is what do you weave in the chill moonlight. Okay, we exchange the places of these two words, that's why it has correct prose order. And our answer is this line has inversion because in this line the arrangement of words is not in a correct prose order. And into the next line you write down the correct prose order is what do you be in the chill moonlight. Okay, in this way, in this poem there is only one example of inversion. Do you understand? Okay, now the next, number 6 figure of speech, interrogation. And it's the main theme of this poem, that the first stanza, you can see the first stanza begins with a question. Second stanza begins with question. Third stanza begins with question. Number 6. Number 6. Interrogation. It's a question. Okay? What is the purpose of that interrogation? That first question, first stanza begins with that question. Here the question is asked. The question is asked to point out more effectively. occur in the sentence. That's why occur in the line. That's why the line has paradox. Now see the example. Weavers weaving Solomon's seal. The example is weavers weaving Solomon's seal. This line has paradox. Why? Because Solomon means serious and still means here quiet. These two words are opposite, contrasting with each other. You also understand here. Now, for what purpose these two contrasting words are used? Here, the idea is Solomon's seal are opposite and it has absurd the statement. Only it's very simple explanation. This line has paradox because in this line the words Solomon's seal, these two are contrasting, these two are opposite and it shows absurd statement. That's why it has paradox. Do you understand? Here is only one example of paradox. Now the next figure of speech is imagery. Imagery. These two last points. Imagery and symbolism. These two figures of speeches are the most important part of our poem because the base of our poem is imagery and symbolism. Okay, what is mean by that imagery? Imagery means the words having visual images. Imagery means the words having visual images, or we can say that this figure of speech or the line create a picture. The line create a picture in our mind. Before we say that, the line create a picture before our mind's eyes, or we can say that the line create a picture in front of our life, in front of our eyes. It means that the words having visual images, we can see, we can imagine that the incident, that the picture in front of our eyes. Now see the example. The example is blue as the wing of halcyon white. Okay, blue as the wing of halcyon white. The second example, like the plumes of peacock. Now I would like to write down all the examples. Like the plumes of peacock. And the third example, white as a feather, white as a cloud. White as a feather and white as a cloud. Now see, in what way we can say that all these three examples have imagery? Because the poem, you know very well that this poem has full of colors. Okay, and this here, the blue, then the plumes of peacock, purple and green. As well as here, white as a feather and white as a cloud. After reading these lines, blue as a wing of halcyon white, because of the word blue, we can see the picture in front of our eyes, that the wings of halcyon bird with blue color. Second one, like the plumes of peacock, plumes with feathers of that peacock, purple and green. Once again, in front of our eyes, there will be the picture of that peacock with the plumes, purple and green. And the last one, white as a feather and white as a cloud. Because of the color white, we can see or we can visualize the image in front of our eyes, that white clouds and white feather. That's why all these three lines had imagery. It's the most important. Why? Because the basic part for you is imagery. Now see the first line. Blue as a wing of halcyon, while in this line the color blue shows innocence. Okay, in the second line, plumes of peacock, purple and green, the purple color shows that here prosperity. And the third one, white as a feather and white as a cloud, shows the end of life. Okay, why I say that? Because this line refers to the childhood. Second one is that indicating youth, and third one is that old age. Okay, symbolism. What is meant by symbolism? Symbolism, a word or an object represent different ideas. In this way, your first line represents the childhood of a person, human being. Second one, youth, and third one, old age. That our childhood, just like that blue color, the wings of